Next, we have to discuss about the one last classification of polymers. That is based on, write down, classification based on molecular forces. Based on molecular forces. Based on molecular forces. So depending upon the strength of the force that is involved in the polymers, this classification is done, okay? And it is important. The first one is elastomers. Write down into this. In short, you write down, these are the polymers in which the intermolecular force of attraction is very weak. Elastomers, in short, you write down point-wise. IMF, that is intermolecular force. So IMF is weakest here. And when IMF is weakest, so obviously the polymers can slide over the layer. Okay, we have layer by layer structure. So when intermolecular force is weak, then all these layers can slide onto each other, right? So that's why they have elasticity property. They have high degree of elasticity. High degree of elasticity. And what we say, they have ability to stretch over, you know, their normal length. Actually, 10 times of their normal length they can stretch, but that is not important. Okay. They have, the structure is irregular, write down, irregular shape. Irregular shape we have, and few cross links are there. And few cross links. Okay. Example you write down. Examples of elastomers are natural rubber. Natural rubber examples. Buna S. You know what is Buna S?
No, sir.
You do not know? Okay. Buna S is a copolymer. We'll discuss that. Buna S is a copolymer. We'll discuss that. Rubber, when we do rubber, we'll discuss into that only. Just write down the example now. Okay, Buna S. So, vulcanized rubber also, here we take as this thing, elastomers. Vulcanized rubber is important. They've asked this question many times in the exam. Vulcanized rubber. So, in this only, we'll discuss what is vulcanized rubber. So write down the heading. Write down. Right on, the vulcanization is a process. Excuse me. Vulcanization is a process by which the tensile strength, elasticity, and resistance of natural rubber can be increased. Okay, next line. In this process, the rubber is heating with sulfur, and in bracket you write down after sulfur, we use 3 to 5% of sulfur. Means the rubber is heating with 3 to 5% of sulfur. During vulcanization, the sulfur bridges. The sulfur bridges or the cross links. Sulfur bridges or the cross links or the cross links. Forms between the polymer chain, and this is known as vulcanized rubber. So basically, the natural rubber you have, suppose the rubber, natural rubber is this. We have different, chain. In this, we have natural rubber is this, suppose. This is natural rubber. And when you heat this with 3 to 5% sulfur, then there will be a crosslink of sulfur bridge between the polymer chain. Like this, suppose the chain we have. So all these will have sulfur bridges present between this, and that is how the strength increases, resistance increases, like this, the chain forms. Okay, so this rubber, we call it as vulcanized rubber. This is natural rubber. So this vulcanized rubber, they have asked many times in the exam, competitive exam also they have asked, in board exam also they have asked, okay? So but there's only one thing you need to keep in mind, that the natural rubber is heated with 3 to 5% sulfur to give the rubber which has more tensile strength, resistance and all, that rubber we call it as vulcanized rubber. Generally, the question that they ask in competitive exam, in vulcanization, the rubber is heated with what? We'll have four options. Sulfur is the answer. Okay. So that is one type of, first classification of molecular, based on molecular forces we have of polymers. Okay. Second one, write down, is fiber. Fiber, write down. In this, the intermolecular, here you see, intermolecular force is weakest here. And here the intermolecular force in fiber is the strongest. Okay, IMF strongest here. Write down. The forces involved in this, next line, the forces involved, you write down, hydrogen bonding. or dipole-dipole interaction. Dipole-dipole interaction. Like in case of polyamides, nylons are polyamides. That also you must remember. Nylons are polyamides. Amide linkage is there. So in case of polyamides, the intermolecular force are due to hydrogen bonding. You must remember this. Polyamide may we have hydrogen bonding. But when you have polyesters, like terylene dacron that you have, polyesters, we have dipole-dipole interaction. In polyester and polyacrylonitrile, that is orlone. See, polyester is dacron. And polyacrylonitrile. Is orlone. So in both we have dipole-dipole interaction. This you must remember for both the thing. Dipole-dipole interaction. So in all these comes under the category of fibers. Okay, they are very strong in terms of their strength. Okay, so when intermolecular forces are strong, they have obviously high tensile strength, the property. They have high tensile strength, okay, and less elasticity. Slippery tendency is not there, hence less elasticity. And the last thing you write down, they have high melting point. High melting point and low solubility. Examples most important. Fibers, the examples are dacron, orlone, and polyamides. Okay, fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so fibers we have done. Next, you write down thermoplastic, the third type. We have thermoplastics. Write down. The polymers in which the intermolecular force, of attraction are in between elastomers and fibers. The intermolecular force of attraction are in between elastomers and fibers. So moderate we have here. These are linear polymers. Hard at room temperature. And become soft and viscous on heating. And again become rigid on cooling. Okay. They become soft and viscous on heating and again become rigid in cooling. Okay. Example you write down. Example you write down. Polyethylene, polypropylene, polystyrene. PVC, Teflon, polyacrylonitrile. Okay. There's a term that we use here is plasticizers. Okay, write down that term in this only, plasticizers. Definition of plasticizers, you write down. Those plastics which do not get soft very much on heating those plastics which do not get soft very much on heating can be made soft and workable by addition of certain organic compound called plasticizers. Those plastics which do not get soft very much on heating can be made soft and workable by the addition of certain organic compounds called plasticizers. Okay, there are some examples of plasticizers you must remember. Diethylphthalates is a one kind of plasticizers. Okay, examples you must remember. Next slide, write down PVC. PVC is extremely stiff. PVC, polyvinyl chloride, is extremely stiff and hard. Extremely stiff and hard, but the addition of dye and butyl phthalate, this one, dye and butyl, PHTHALATE. This is the general name. This is one specific example we are taking. Okay. PVC is extremely stiff and hard, but the addition of diethylmethyl phthalate, in short, in bracket you write down, we also call it as DBP, diethylmethyl phthalate, makes it soft and rubber-like. Okay. Dioctyl phthalate is the another example. Dioctyl, PHTHALATE, in short we write it DOP, is the another example of this plasticizes. Okay. Structure of this, you see, thalic acid is this, benzene ring, and we have COOH here. But that H you removed by butyl group, C4H9. It becomes DBP, C4H9. Okay, octyl is what? C8H17 you need to put here. So this is the structure of octyl. COO, C8H17, COO, C8H17. This is DOP and this is DBP. This two plasticizers you must remember. Okay. So this is one thing. Cresyl phosphate also we use as a plasticizers. Another example, the last one you write down. Cresyl phosphate. The structure is this. ME. And here we have O, P double bond O, OH, double bond O. This is orthocresyl phosphate, another plasticizers. Okay, so these three examples you must remember. Done?
Yes, sir.